everybody! Today I'm showing you a kind of color blocking card with this cute stamp set from Create a Smile. It's from the last release. It's all about magnolias. And I used this purple tape and my favorite kind of paper. It's Exacompta paper. And it comes in the right size. And I love it, especially when I work with distress inks. Yes, I have to say sorry because somehow I went with all my stuff to the bottom of this video frame. I think it's nearly okay, but yes, I hope you are not angry or it's not too annoying to you that I'm a little bit out of my frame. So I'm starting with this purple tape. I normally used a different kind of tape and had always a lot of struggles by ripping the paper off when I remove the tape. But this purple tape is really a winner. I love it so much. A friend of mine sent it to me and I'm so happy with this. But I'm so on the other side. Today it ripped my paper. I was a little bit sad, but later I can tell you more. So I started to separate my paper in these, I think it was 5 little spaces. And yes, I had no rules or no plan for this. I did it as it come. And then I took my Distress Oxides in the colors Picked Raspberry, Twisted Citron, Phosphonoid Amber, Broken China, and Seedless Preserved. I'm so bad at pronouncing these colors. Yes, and then took some sticky notes to save all the other parts of my card. And for changing the colors, so I took the pink and the velvet, or the, what is it, kind of purple. I took the same sheet of paper, but I didn't want that the pink color is floating into my blue color, so then I would have a kind of purple. And this I wanted to avoid. That is why I took some more of these sticky papers or sticky notes. And at the end, at the green and at the yellow, I also took some new ones. I think these both are similar colors. So there would be no problem when a little bit of the green comes into the yellow, because they look so similar. So yes, I put all the colors in all these spaces. And it's, yes, it's very easy and not a big effort. And when I finished that part, then as always when I use Distress Ink or Distress Oxides, I use some water drops all over the paper and dried it with a paper towel or paper tissue. Yeah. And so this is my card base, my finished. And yes, now I remove it from my workspace and put it into the Misty tool. Between these steps, I also used my heating tool, but I cut it out for you, because I wanted to dry these water drops a little bit, that I will have no struggles with stamping on it. Maybe it the color from the stamps could be not so clear or crisp. And yes, now I stamp one of these magnolias into each of these parts from my card. I in this stamp set, there's also a bigger magnolia bouquet, but I didn't want to use my bigger stamping tool because I do not like it so much as I like my Misty. On my wish list is still the bigger Misty, because I like it the most, maybe because of the soft ground. So that is why I only use these smaller flowers from the stamp set. So it's not so surprising, or not surprising is the right word. So each part looks a little bit similar, and I would have get into the card more, what is the word, more changing when I've used the third stamp. But I think it's okay. So, and I have to say, I had some real struggles with the video today. I stared at my stamps and I was near to crying because I had no idea. I did my first video and I didn't like it, and oh, it was not a good day for me. So I'm at least very happy that I have a card I like at the end of the day. But please forgive me when I was a little bit lazy in some steps of this card. So here comes my heating tool again, because I do not want to smear with my fingers some colors around, but at the end I had some little mistakes, but you don't see it. Yes, but the last days I had this problem more often, that I come with my fingers on the fresh inked stamp image, and yes, I'm always so angry. But I always manage to cover it a little bit so that nobody can see it. So yes, here I took black paper and die cut a circle, and then I used this wonderful sentiment set from Create a Smile. It's Decorate Wishes, the mixed add-on, so there are only sentiments in the set, and I love it totally, and it's perfect for kind of round sentiments. So yeah, now comes the greatest part of the video, the big reveal of these purple tape. And here you can see, the paper is sticking on. So, yes, the trick is from Christina. She always uses her heating tool for removing her tapes. And yes, it worked really fine. And if you remove your tape very slowly, sorry. I'm so sorry. So if you remove it really slowly, you can stop early enough before anything really bad happens to your card. So and you can use your heat tool to save your paper. So this is a final moment. I'm so lucky about this. And yes, at the end I thought a little bit smaller purple tape would have been a little bit better, but nevertheless I like it. And these ripped off paper I cut away, yeah, so nobody sees my mistakes. And now there comes finally the cardstock. I put this panel on with some double-sided foam tape, as I use it very often, and I really love to have these 3D effects on cards. Do you use it also on every card and on every image? I like when they pop out of the card. So this is the back side. Oh, back side. Some S trouble. Put it on the card, and then there's only this little sentiment missing. And yes, I'm out of words now. But we are near to the end of the video, so I think I do not need so many more words anymore. So yes, here's a sentiment. I put it on the card. Oh, I have to talk slowly. And yes, I hope you like this card. I hope you like this video. And thank you so much for watching. And yes, I'm wishing you a nice day. Bye bye.